stop him. This spirit must leave him.
Amen.
It's a spirit of stagnation. Come on. The spirit of stagnation. Come on. What I do to him? Huh? Want to vomit? Come on. Spirit of stagnation. Come out. Leave him. Vomit this thing. The spirit of stagnation. They are giving him food.
Amen.
When he's asleep. They are giving him food. That's why you see him vomiting. He dream eating. Dream eating. Vomit everything. Vomit everything. Allow me to say, when you're a pastor and you were attacked like him, listen to this. We were older. When we advise you, don't be intimidated. If you see a person like me advising you and I'm older than you, it's not a threat. It's a lesson. When a person of your age advises you, it's an intimidation. A person like me, when I say, don't do this, do that, I'm not threatening you. It's an advice. It's not a threat, it's an advice. It's a lesson. Take it like a lesson. But if you take it like a threat, you are questionable. Because you can't compete with somebody like me who have already been old.
You know.
Like old people, you take advice from them. There's a spirit of stagnation.
It's
you
are
strong.
Facing.
Yeah, it's true.
But now it's very tough now. It's very tough now.
It's true.
And you are getting this thing because when you sleep, they feed you.
Yes.
You dream eating.
Yes, I eat.
And that's why you see yourself vomiting.
Yes.
So today, you are free.
Thank you, Jesus. Amen. Thank you. Thank you, Jesus.
My advice is, because I'm older than you, when I'm advising you is, you people, you need the word of God. The word of God is, the word of God, we don't read it to preach to others. We read it to live our lives.
Amen.
If you want to prosper in life, take the word of God. The word of God, don't steal, you steal. And you are preaching it. When you cast the one who steal, you are casting yourself. In the last day, when you say I was preaching, Jesus said, I don't know you because already you have casted yourself. So a person like you, you need the word of God.
Amen.
You understand?
Yes.
Yes. And then after you have been delivered, you see Satan is following you.
Satan following you.
They're attacking you so that you stop everything. You lose everything. In fact, you're on the verge of losing all.
Yeah, it's very true. Because I was even scared to go and start the ministry.
Yeah?
I was scared even to go and start the ministry.
My advice to a person like you, you find a church, you sit down. You revived again by the word of God. You understand? Until you see that your life and the word of God are not separable. That's how you'll make it.
Amen.
Because if you can see, Satan is still taking you back.
Satan also wishes him around.
It's true.
It's not true.
Yeah, I was giving up.
Eh?
I was giving up everything.
You're giving up everything.
Everything.
So I'm not talking about giving up. I'm talking about taking you back to the lifestyle.
Yeah,
it's true. It's true.
Lifestyle you were living before.
It's true.
So my advice to you is, stay in the church, find a church. Even if you're not coming, there are many churches. You sit there, you study the Bible. Until you see that my life now, with the Bible, they correspond. If not, these spirits are more powerful to the weak people. They are still going to come to you. But God loves you so much.
Thank you.
I say God loves you.
Amen.
You'll make it.
Amen. Amen.
The way I see you, you are going to make it.
I receive.
So
I receive.
God bless you.
Thank you.
Amen.
So himself is delivered because he's also opening his heart. Some of you, when I come to you, your heart is still...